Good evening, guys. We're looking at the last day of the Pro League season for the Indian League Gaming. We're looking at OG versus AX right now. I'm here accompanied by Crocker Rocker.
Crocker Rocky. Wesley, you're meant to know me.
Okay, well, I know him as Billy, but today I'll call him Crocker Rock.
You can call me Billy, it's fine. I'm sure they're understand.
Okay, then, Billy. thank God.
Anyway, so we got a Zed ban coming out here against the purple side, which is AX, and then the Jarvan against Zarzus, which is a pretty target ban considering he's been doing so well on him of late. The Kha'Zix has got to be a target ban as well because that isn't very strong in this meta, so that's always interesting.
Alright, so exactly, you're right. It's probably a target ban, the Kha'Zix.
Zarath. That's interesting. Considering Evil Dead's performance on the Orianna last game, I would have been watching that and making my decision off what they were doing.
All right, so one thing I had in my mind is Jungly. Is he going to be the jungler of the team? Do you have any idea about AX?
Pardon?
Do you know is Jungly their second pick? Do you think he's going to go jungle?
I don't know. I know AX don't no longer have Go Rivens because there was a problem with forms and stuff, so he's no longer playing with them. I believe it's I don't know who their replacement was actually.
Alright. Okay, so now we see an Irelia ban coming in.
Irelia's a pretty solid pick though. So
a
therefore
pretty safe
I think
top pick on top.
Though you have to remember these powerhouses of top lane, Gnar and Lissandra, both still available. So it'd be interesting. Vi got banned out. So
the last second Vi ban happening right there.
I wonder whether
really
Lissandra or Gnar's going to be picked up here. The priorities seem to be prioritizing the Morgana over them, though.
Exactly. Probably on the bottom lane, getting the Morgana pick, making sure that they put supports like Leona out of the question. And we see Jungly, instead of going jungle, he's going to go AD carry, probably. Going with the Caitlyn right now, hovering over Caitlyn right now, and we're waiting for Incarnation's pick.
Yeah. Yeah, no.
And it's a new day.
No, oh, that can't be right. That's not going to be a new day. No way could that be a new day.
What if it is going to be a new day?
It's too early to pick a new day, surely, because that Morgana, he's not going to be able to gank bot lane, is he?
Well, probably not, but the Black Shield, it makes it really hard for Uther to gain, especially
yeah,
with
the
snare.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. There we go, that's
and
something more
there
appropriate.
We go. That's more appropriate. We
and
get
the Varus is an old pick. Oh,
Rek'Sai. Rek'Sai.
And this is pre-nerf, so this isn't 5.... But this isn't 5.1, this is 4.21, so this... Therefore, the nerfs haven't come out on Rek'Sai yet, so he's still overpowered. And that's a lock-in on the Varus, which is quite interesting, because if he gets caught by a Dark Binding... It was a pretty good pick, was it one or two games ago? So that was interesting. Let's see who these guys go for, because right now, this Varus is going to struggle in the lane if he does manage to get caught by a Dark Binding. And
Lucian as well, that's going to be even more
Lucian,
trouble for Varus right now.
Lucian is going to punish this Varus, but Varus' late game is still pretty strong.
Varus' late game is pretty strong, and the CC in the end and the crazy amounts of AoE damage will come in handy. But will that be enough to face
oh,
the
game? Oh, the Amumu look in! Oh. The picks are going crazy! And the Gnar lock in! Here we go!
Oh, alright, so pretty cool stuff
that's
we're seeing.
That's gotta be
right
a
now.
Lissandra being top. That's gotta be a Lissandra pick top coming out though, because from OG, because there is no way that they can match Gnar otherwise. And look at the team fight coming out from AX right now. I know OG's got it there, but they've just got like they can engage at any point because Sejuani can just throw her ult down like it's a couple of people if I catch the engage. And the Riven, is that going to be mid? This would be
is that going to be a Riven mid? Ooh, here comes the hard carries coming from Riven from the mid lane. But then again, the enemy.
No.
Oh,
it's Katarina.
Oh,
this is just looking to be an absolute troublemaker for OG right now, because this team fight is looking deadly.
I know, with Damien picking up that Katarina, there's a lot of CC coming up from Sejuani as well. That's going to mean a lot of kills for Katarina in the mid game. Yeah. I love mid game.
And ooh, GP, and please lock that GP. I would love to. Oh, a Swain. Now,
a Swain and a Gangplank. What do you think about this team composition? Do you think they're going to lock in the Gangplank?
I don't. Do you I think hope. That, I hope for OG's sake they're not going to lock in the Gangplank, especially versus Anar. I can't imagine it's going to do. There's
oh,
a Lissandra
right
that
about
I was
the
talking
Lissandra
about.
Pick.
But that's
is
going,
that
going
to go
that's
on the
mid. Yeah, which is slightly interesting.
Oh, and the Gangplank is locked in!
We've got a good game here, guys. And Evil Dead's floating around to pick what he wants. But I think that Lissandra would be good. But the Fizz is also not a bad pickup. I
this
think
is
Lissandra,
also
just
idea.
Because Twisted Fate.
Now, that is a pick which... Oh, Syndra. Okay, he's just confusing
and
us
this is
right
pre-Syndra nerf as well, because Syndra got nerfed. Oh.
Or never mind,
let's just not
so
say anything about his champions until he actually...
Yeah, let's just ignore him now. Let's just ignore him.
Let's talk about this Three. GP. The... how is he gonna go against Gnar? The Ahri is a good pickup. The Challenger Ahri skin isn't out on the Garena server yet, is it?
No, it's probably not. Let me check whether it is.
It's out now, and it's only just come out within the last couple of days. The Janna pickup would be quite nice, but the Lulu's not too bad either. The Lulu would probably be a better pickup considering their team comp.
Or the
Leona for the team fight. All I was thinking is the Lulu for the protect. Like she could just ult the Katarina.
Or what about the hooks? Or the get in hooks? What is it going to be? Hook inwards or outwards? Is it going to be Leona or Blitzcrank? Or are they going to go for a knockup with Lulu?
I don't know.
Let's go back to the Gangplank though. I'm still pretty excited
this
about the Gangplank.
I'm just gonna look and see if I can find any Like, I know this website LOL counter a while ago. I can't imagine that Gangplank is a particularly good counter pick into this Gnar. I don't see what they're going for with the Gangplank here. I'm not gonna lie.
Exactly. I'm pretty excited to see the Gangplank, though, because sometimes when a Gangplank does get fed... When a Gangplank does get fed, a game does turn out to be crazy.
Right. According to, I'm just checking out LOL skill. LOL counter. It's some counter website. I haven't used it for quite a long time, but because I haven't seen this matchup before. But apparently, he does have the advantage in lane Gangplank. I guess this is just because of his Q poke. It's a more reliable source of poke, and Gangplank also has his movement speed with his Eve.
Glacial Shroud. The Static Shift Frozen Iceborne Gauntlet combo with the Q does hurt pretty badly. And there's a lot of crit happening there too. Maybe they're going for the crazy poke to avoid the team fight potential that comes from the other team.
But still, if Gangplank steps forward to poke, then Sejuani is just going to destroy him. Or Leona's going to destroy him. Why is that? I think we've got a hell of a game coming in for us.
Exactly, all the champions have locked in. They're about to start the loading screen right now. We're going to see a 3-minute delay into the games. The delay is always really nice, so that some of the players can't really stream on Twitch on the other account and look at what's happening. Thank God that doesn't work out.
Yeah, though I guess you're pretty upset. We've seen a Diana play today.
We did?
No, we haven't seen any Diana play.
Yeah, I probably don't think anyone's going to pick Diana, especially in team compositions. Remember when we tried to make a team around Diana and it didn't work?
Yeah, no. I'll just go Aurelia and then just kind of roll that lane. But this Gnar versus Gangplank is going to be one interesting lane. And now, I do believe, mechanically speaking, just because of the rank discrepancy, Gangplank is gonna have the advantage in terms of he probably knows more.
Right, but then again, you see, one thing that happens in Garena is a lot of people who are stuck in silver or bronze. Definitely not bronze. People who are in platinum or silver or gold. Sometimes they play really good, and sometimes they can match up against challengers. It happens sometimes.
How many people are there to these servers in terms of? Is there a lot, or is there...
Well, there's definitely a lot. Most of the players from Garena, who play in Garena, are, from Southeast Asia.
Taiwan,
places like that, too. There's a crazy ton of players. And you know India and Bangladesh, though, we're crazy populated. We have a lot of people playing.
Yeah. Now, even though OG are meant to be one of the best teams in India, I genuinely think right now, looking at these teams, AX... I'm going to give it to AX if they can hold out the laning phase and not get so far behind.
Exactly, if they can hold out behind, because their teamfight potential is so much better. You have to admit, like, Gangplank, it's a very good Gangplank, can put a lot of hurt onto the Gnar, especially if he misses the skull shots.
Yeah, but at the same time, if Syntastic can handle his Rage Bar, fine. If he's a good Gnar player, then I'll be interested to see what happens.
Exactly, and let's look at the mid lane matchup right now. Ari picking up that exhaust for that Katarina does not want that ult to do that much damage, does she?
Or he? Not at all. Or Bell. Though, it's the same as playing against the Zed. If you save your taunt, you can just get him straight out of it. Like, wait for them to E up, and then... Damien, is he the guy that got replaced...
Ooh, and the game's about to begin. The loading screen starts for us right now. It's been 3 minutes since the game actually started for these guys. Alright, so,
Right, I believe the original squad was Incarnation, Jungly, Go Riven, Syntastic, and Damien. So the sub for AX would be... Zabardust. Zabardust. Yeah. So that's
Zabardust.
Zabardust. I'm not saying it right.
It's a Hindi word. It's Zabardust.
Zabardust. Alright. I'm going to make my best to pronounce it. Damien is the mid laner for AX, guys.
Fantastic on Gnar, who's the top laner, and Jungle.
No, I wish I had one of those borders. Look at those nice borders.
I'll probably never get borders like these.
I'm looking for plat this season, mate. I'm looking for plat. Because remember, I got gold,
I just want gold so I can get that skin. I want to be victorious for once.
I think I've played, like... I don't think I've played the Morgana since, like, about the first couple of days of actually getting the skin.
Yeah, you went crazy on that Morgana.
Yeah, that's because I got the skin. But I did end up getting, like, 20 kills or something, so...
Oh, what mystery gift did you get from Europe?
I got Red Card Twist of Fate on my Smurf, and on my main, I got Dragon Fist Lee Sin.
Oh, God. All I got was Explorer Ezreal.
Oh, I've already got that. It's so terrible. But I have TPA.
I know. It's. I'm pretty upset, right? Some guys got Brolaf. I would have loved a Brolaf.
Apparently, we're meant to report AX for no skins, guys. So, oh, we've already got a pause. Brutality.
Yeah, we got a pause. This happens every day. This happens pretty much every game. We've gone through two games without a pause. Those are the two best games of our lives. but sadly, whichever game I've cast,
I don't know.
We've seen
you weren't here
pauses.
For last game, Wessie. The last game was good.
It was good.
Yeah.
What happened last game?
It was just a very good game. It was quite intense. The team fights were brilliant. So there was a lot of pauses, but but anyway, yeah. I'm really looking forward to about the 15-20 minute stage or when dragons start getting contested like a level 6 or something like that, because I doubt either team's going to be wanting to go for much pre-6, because let's be honest, Cat hits a spike at 6, Gnar hits a spike at 6, Sejuani hits a spike at 6. Yeah, everyone...
So does Ari, Mumu, Lucian...
Everyone on AX hits a spike at 6. Whereas OG could possibly pressure slightly beforehand, because Ari still has a lot of power pre-6, and so does Lucian.
Yeah, she does. Especially with the range and the charm.
I've got a mess.
Exactly. One thing that Gnar's going to have above Gangplank, though, is it's literally a battle of skill for Gnar's standpoint. If he can make all of his skill shots, he'll be giving Gnar a hard... He'll be giving Gangplank a hard time. Yeah. But if that doesn't work out, though...
Right, it's getting on pause. 2-1. Are you 2-2-3-4? Are you about the same time as me, yeah?
I'm at 6 seconds. What about you?
8, 9, 10, 11.
11.
Yeah,
12.
We're about the same. We're about the same.
Location, are we at the same time? Alright, great. Let's begin.
From this, OG's going to go for an invade. They're all grouping up together. So,
exactly.
Though they did this last game, so I don't know why, AX aren't actually expecting this coming in, though. That is a odd half. Let's have a look at the builds here. Gangplank
for
that sustain.
And they get the snare onto it. A lot of damage coming in.
Charm was missed, though. That's going to be a disadvantage for Ahri in lane now. She's taken and completely missed it.
Exactly. Not really coming up with any of the spoils, going up with the charm, but Leona... really well aware of that being the only form of CC that they have right now, except for Morgana's Snare, goes for the juke.
Zabadass, though, has got to feel a little bit... I expect he's, like, he was just over... I don't know. He saw them coming. He could have backed off a little bit beforehand. I think it's just pressure getting into him playing.
Ooh, and we see Zabardust. And we see Zabardust say thank you on all chat. That is some cool stuff right there. Leona made it out in spite of getting snared from a 5-man team level 1 gank. Made it out safely without too much damage.
The bad Ahri either. Oh, and
ooh,
a good Ahri.
But then
there's
a good Ahri coming in, but it's not as useful as the last one. Katarina just laughs it off.
Is that Emumu there? Is that skin? Emumu? Or whatever it is?
Emumu. Yeah, Emumu. Yeah.
I am a fan of this Arc like Varus skin, though. It's much better.
It's a pretty nice. I love this one. It's his best skin. It makes him look really cool. Alright, so now we're going to look at Sejuani going on with the Gromp, and we're going to see the Gromp coming in from Emumu as well.
Pat should actually go for the early game pressure, and it's quite odd that OG didn't opt to start on the... getting the early golems to hit the level 2 first.
Exactly, they had the opportunity to go get it, but they didn't go for it though. They could have hit the level 2 and had
even more of an advantage in lane. But I guess maybe they feel like they've got enough advantage without going for it.
Look at all that poke coming in, and that snare just missing out.
Now, it is actually pretty bad first wave CS from Brutality, missing 3 CS in the first wave.
Exactly. But kind of making up for it, though, as the fact that Varus is going to have a much harder time as well with very low health, even though it's just the early level ones.
Frost just isn't giving up, though, is he? Look at him.
Ooh, and another charm coming in from Ahri that
Katarina,
Q completely misses.
Damien's
doing
some
that
work.
Hit. Exactly, and the Q lands onto the minion on the bot lane. And one thing I do got to say is Ahri's hitting his charms, but the Qs aren't going that well.
Yeah, that's true.
Right now, they both might be even in farm right now, but this is not the time when Ahri and Katarina should be equal in CS, especially from Ahri's standpoint.
Yeah, I mean, that Katarina seems to be doing quite well. That's interesting, actually. You see, most cats, I don't think Kat gets any professional play really. So you see most cats usually going boots 4. But this cat's opted for the Doran
shield. Exactly. Probably does not want that Ahri poke to hit her.
All the auto attacks from the farming.
The auto attack pressure can mean a lot. And that's actually doing a lot of good work for Katarina, being pretty safe in lane right now.
And the snare hits up. Look at that. This is going to be, and the ignite comes up.
Makes it out in time. First blood actually goes down to Lucian.
How did he get that kill?
I have no idea. Wish we had an instant replay for that, but are we going to see a replay of it right now? But no, it's Morgana who takes the kill. Very good early game lead from Team OG right now.
And Ahri actually apparently made it out for...
Got ganked and is going to get ganked again. This is going to be a return kill. And Sejuani picks up that kill?
I bet that Katarina wanted that kill, so she might be feeling a little bit salty there.
Probably a little bit sulky over there. I thought that she took the kill as well. The Ignite was running. She had that last auto attack on.
I think it was, I can't remember
the
name. The
AoE coming from Sejuani that did the damage.
It was Sejuani's flail of the Northern Winds, which I call Wavy Stick, because that's pretty much all he does, just wave the stick.
Exactly, so... Alright, so now we're going to see a flash burn from Ahri and the Exhaust as well. Gonna be pretty hard for her to lane right now. This looks pretty bad for the Ahri right now.
Now, there's a fun fact about Sejuani. If there was a fresh in this game, you'd actually only receive one soul from the Sejuani, even though you receive two souls from a Nunu. That's because, genuinely speaking, this is a true fact, because Sejuani, the rider, is ginger, and you actually only get the soul from her boar.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm serious. That's, that was a
way to give it to Lee to make jokes like that, though.
I know.
Oh, really hard coming on to that. And another kill. Varus is not having a good time in that lane.
I bet Brutality's
exactly.
But then
again, same thing's happening on the mid lane on the other side of things.
What is this game? This mid pressure, they are just destroying Evil Dead this game.
Exactly, Evil Dead being constantly ganked without the flash, without the exhaust, doesn't really have anything going for her right now. Already 13 CS behind Katarina at this point, and level 5 to Katarina's level. Well, actually, they're actually quite equal in level, but we're pretty sure exactly right there. Katarina's level 6 right now. Ari's probably a lot further ahead from level 6.
I don't know this about this Gangplank pick, though. It's not seeming to work out for OG over here.
Exactly.
He's behind in CS. I don't see him having a better late game above than Gnar. I think Alessandra would have just been a better pickup, including for the team.
Is he away? No, that good last second juke. Good grief, that was amazing.
I feel
amazing.
Like the flash was a little bit too much there.
Exactly, that flash was a little unnecessary, kind of overkill, but I guess he wanted to play it really safe, not giving any more kills to that bottom lane. Look at that Lucian right now. 13 CS ahead, but no, that Leona.
Going for him every time.
Ooh, and another snare. Frost is going crazy right now. Is he from Azubu? I do not know.
No,
exactly, but have you
just
seen those snares after snares? It's probably coming from the excellent play coming from Frost, landing every single snare.
And
can't
Ari
say the same about Evil
Dead
right now. He's having a pretty hard time.
Level 6 now, and, ooh, and she's going for the all in. There's nothing's going to go for it.
And look at that Sejuani, always coming in for that mid lane. Yeah, she's camping that lane right now. Does not want that Ari to have a good time at all. Trying to get that Katarina ahead as much as possible.
See, right now, bot lane could even go for a dive if their jungler came over, because that Gangplank could just ult the bot side. He is now level 6, so he could easily do it. They're seeming pretty low. He could completely zone them.
Ooh, and the Scrying Orb coming in from Varus, looking onto that Morgana. But I don't really see the point.
I feel like it was obvious that he was there. She was there.
Did the snare land? No, it didn't. And Katarina's dancing. Look at Katarina just...
She has been dancing quite a bit. Like, she knows she's ahead now.
And look at that ping coming up from Umumu to make Ari ward that side of the blue. Ari takes down blue, but I don't know if that's going to be much of use to her. Is Katarina go for the jug? No. This is one thing I like.
Oh, they are waiting. He is waiting. Is he going to wait around? Get the kill? That's quite an interesting first couple of items coming from Brutality right here. A Vamp Scepter and a Longsword. Maybe he's suggesting that he's going for the Blade of the Rune King route.
And did Katarina disconnect, or is she just taunting right now?
I think DC'd.
Well, then we should have seen a pause coming
DC,
right now.
DC. Well, aren't they pausing?
But the thing is, it's actually coming up from...
There's
we see the pause right now.
Yeah.
There's the pause. That was definitely a disconnection.
Yeah, that was, good manners by Evil Dead right there, though. He only got one Q on there and then just stopped and just started typing going DC. So there's good manners. Props to Evil Dead right there. He could have taken a kill, but... And helped himself out quite a lot.
Especially, I would have totally taken that kill.
If it was ranked solo queue, I definitely would have.
Exactly, and we see a good amount of sportsmanship coming up. Not too much coming from Damien, though. Totally spamming the dance and the laughs while laning against Ari, who had a terrible time because of all the Sejuani ganks. However, Katarina did not pick up a kill.
I think it's also... to be fair, the amount of time I totally baited someone into a fight the other day by just literally taunting them with my laugh. We took the Riven in, and the Riven was the only one that was fed on the team. And you just taunt them in by doing that kind of thing. It may seem like BM, but it's actually a decent tactic, because this Riven just got impatient, jumped straight in, and we got the CC down on the Riven and just destroyed her and turned the game around, because I kept doing it, and obviously this Riven had a short patience. So maybe Katarina's just trying to taunt Evil Dead in to try fight her 1v1, because her jungler was there at the time. So, I can see why she was trying to taunt her into it.
Exactly, that does sound like a tactic which has been quite used. I actually like spamming my taunts as well whenever I'm having a good time in lane.
Yeah, I mean, it's not the nicest thing to do in the world, but...
It's sort of a dick move, but then again, I guess we all do it at some point. Who doesn't want to be the bully?
Yeah.
Right, Billy? Ha! Pun. Alright, so...
How do you even...
So, as you were saying, how do
you carry on. I was just curious, who actually gets to pause these games?
Since this is a tournament, it's a tournament draft beat-up, So the first picks of every team, they can pause the game. So it's pretty much down to the guys whose first pick, I think.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Let's have another look at this top lane. There's not too much of a CS discrepancy, but currently GP has obviously only just picked up his Avarice play because he's only got 37 gold on it, but he's already going for that.
Billy, can you give me a second?
That's
I'm gonna
fine.
Be back in a second.
I can solo cast for a while. So let's just talk to the viewers right here. Anything that you want me to talk about, or you guys wanna? Yeah, Wes is gone. He's on the phone, I assume. Anything that you guys want to bring up here? Who's active in client? Any discussion points? I genuinely think that AX might take this game. They want me to talk about... Galio.
Want to talk about what?
I've asked people what they want us to talk about, because I was on my own, so someone's saying Galio. Oh, the game is resuming, so we might talk about Galio later if we get another pause. There's popcorn and Galio.
Galio, like the champion Galio?
Yeah, the champion Galio.
We'll talk about that later. And the snare missing.
Oh, wow,
look at this.
Is going to be gone, and the gangplank stole the kill and the blue buff.
That was an amazing kill. Coming up from Gangplank right there, that was pure skill, timing the Gangplank ult at the right second to get that kill.
Now, I think the team's going to be pretty happy with Gangplank getting that blue buff, because now he's going to be able to eat his oranges for days, and he's going to be able
I'm pretty sure that during team speak, Gangplank's like, I want that kill, give me that kill right now, I need that blue buff. Alright, now we're going to see, we see the Avarice Blade and the Glacier Shroud coming up, so we're gonna see Fizzbar and Ice Gauntlet coming up from Gangplank and the Static Shift. So I was pretty much right about that build. Pretty standard stuff with the Q poke.
Oh, to one of the viewers, I am from the south of the UK. I'm not gonna say much more than that because, you know. And look at this gang right here.
Exactly.
About where Gangplank
is almost about to go kill him. Oh, that's a kill.
Oh, he let Morgana have it.
Morgana nicked that kill off. She's on a killing spree right now. She is fed.
Frost is showing people up this game with all these snares. Maybe OG are looking to go for a dragon or something right about now. They could actually. Everyone's a little bit too far away to do it. Really, Gangplank needs his ult, because if they go for it, Gangplank can just ult and go for it.
Exactly. And Gangplank's gonna have the teleport come back in a bit too. Oh, and we see Gnar. Telling Frost to please cool it, pretty harsh right now. We see Gangplank with a CS lead right now, so things are looking pretty good for OG.
I told you that blue buff would do him wonders, because look at him, full HP. It's full HP, and he's doing well, and he's going to be able to keep it up as long as he's got that blue buff rolling. And you can poke all day. He looks like he's gonna back. How much gold is he sitting on?
Ooh, and the bounce onto the cannon minion. Did you see that, Billy?
Currently, that Gangplank is sitting on 2,000 gold. So, let's see what he comes back with. He's got
a frozen heart.
Damn. Wait, who did
that? That is a tank plank right now.
The Katarina
was disconnected. Ooh, pretty bad time for them to take Baron then. That must have been pretty unfortunate. That Sejuani coming out with
Leona going down most likely.
That's what the Q. Ari takes on over that kill.
Sejuani
with a desperate attempt to take the dragon, but that didn't work. Risking her life for the dragon.
Didn't have his TP. That was the issue. There was good timing all round and an unlucky timing for that cat, because...
Exactly, the disconnection may have actually meant something. Having to pop
that flash, she is dead.
A dead Katarina right now. Things are looking pretty bad, very bad.
This looks like it's going to snowball out of control, and they're just making the picks everywhere. They're making the right rotations. Like, right now, someone can rotate top and get that Gnar again. Things are not looking good for AX right now.
Exactly. The only way AX can come back right now from the game is like another good dragon fight, and maybe a few good teamfights. They need to group up together as soon as a few more turrets go down. They need to take a turret, basically, is what I'm saying.
Yeah, no, I totally agree. They need to start getting some map pressure. They need to make these team fights before it snowballs too late out of control. Because look at him running away. He's a fast guy, isn't he?
He was thinking about counter jungling, but then he saw the big ball.
Look at that Gnar about to go into ult there. No, about to go into a pass like Mega Gnar there.
Distinct is totally respecting
his laning opponent right now. He is just waiting to get all like his items stacked.
Ooh, and a very smart ward coming in from Gangplank.
And what is it? He put it over the wall. It's a good.
Yeah, he put it over the wall.
Now I reckon this Gangplank, even though the CS is like actually leading towards fantastic, I reckon Gangplank's got a decent CS.
Ooh, and the flash having to be popped out.
This thing's got all,
but she decided to use the flash instead.
And
ooh,
that's dead. And I thought he was going for the KS
with
again.
Another kill. Evil's dead, having a much better time than she did before. Who's the one laughing now? I guess.
Yeah, that's true. Now, actually, it's quite interesting. This Gangplank has 1,000 gold lead in top lane.
Wow, that is actually quite crazy. Probably coming from the assists and the kills right now.
Well, and this Gangplank, so he just gets off his Q, and then obviously the Avarice Blade. Let's see how much that is ramping up. 214 off the Avarice Blade alone. And then off his Q, he's got 430 gold off that, so he is raking it up. He's playing the champion well.
Exactly, probably a pretty good Gangplank pick. Do you think this Gangplank play warrants a ban, though?
No. I think the Lissandra would have been a better pick still. He's playing it well, but the Lissandra would have been better. He could have like punished the Gnar in lane, shut the Gnar down a little bit more, because this Gnar is still going to be a problem for the entirety of OG.
Look at the poke he's getting on Gangplank right now. Just three minutes ago, Gangplank and Gnar were equal in CS, but Gnar took back the lead again.
And you have to remember, currently, Gangplank has 176 armor. It might not seem like Gnar's doing much damage at this point. But look at this gank coming in top lane. Here we go. The good Gnar escape. That was a very good escape.
That was very tricky stuff. Pretty good Gnar play. You know, Team AX still has the game in their hands, though. If they still somehow manage to rally up and create some good team fights, they can easily take back the favor.
People talk about how there's not going to be any Baron throws at high elo plays, but that is far from true. I don't know how many LCS games you guys have seen, but there's been plenty of Baron throws on there.
One thing about Baron, though, is like no one's been doing too many Barons because Baron's been so much stronger than it used to be before, and we're going to see, the perfect,
he might have just saved himself.
Is that
going to
save Sejuani's? No, it's not. Gangplank's the one who takes that kill, and forcing Katarina to shoot and pull out, probably going to spell more trouble.
Gangplank is just getting himself fed. He might want to go for a Sword of the Occult at this rate. He's actually looking to go, I don't know what he's going, actually. He might be going Triforce, though at the same time he might be going
for the Gauntlet.
Yeah, I suppose.
Could be the Gauntlet. That does give a lot more AoE CC.
But right, you have to remember, right now, he's already got more than enough armor. 189 armor at this point. If anything, he'd be wanting HP.
That does come with a Trinity Force, but let's just see what he picks up next. Could be either or. Either way, it's going to give an advantage for the team.
I think too much armor, and he's just going to be blown up by that cat, because he's going to need some HP for that.
Exactly. Katarina going balls deep in, trying to go take that Ahri. But Ahri
and look,
back up
wait,
and
hold on. We've been ignoring something on this bot side. Look at that split push.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow. This is just going out of control right now. Oh, geez.
Exactly. Will Leona get the kill? Leona get the kill?
Yes, she will. She sliced and diced him up. Oh, and look at that.
Yes, she does, but that does not come without her own doom and Morgana.
Look at Morgana
on a rampage.
Oh, but is Brutality going to get the kill?
Ooh, and Brutality's on a rampage, too. Both the bot laners are on a rampage.
He's going ham.
Lucian going ham. Oh, and a double kill. That actually worked out,
but
how
is
Lucian going to get himself
dead?
Out of this?
That is the question.
How is he going to get out of this?
He's going to dash.
There, oh, he's going to dash. Obviously.
I was just, because that cat was up and...
Well, that would have been bad news for Lucian right now, but he managed to go get the double kill. He's 5-0-2 right now.
DFG pickup on the Katarina is quite interesting, considering that item's being taken out of the game right now, so it's actually a good pickup, because it's obviously quite a strong item.
You won't see those anymore. Won't see those items anymore. Do you miss DFG?
It's not out of the game yet, but it's soon to be. Also, you can just see the discrepancy between gold between mid laners, because look how much further ahead. There's about 1.2k gold difference between the mid laners right now. I'll just have a double check on the gold scoring, but it's about 1.6k gold difference between the mid laners. That's a lot. And let's have a look at the 80 carries. It's There's like another one. Wow, that's a huge gold lead. That's over 2.6k gold lead to Lucian right now.
Exactly.
That is
Lucian
about
has...
the Yumu's Ghostblade, isn't it?
Lucian actually also has 13% lifesteal right now. And he has full CDR. Not full CDR, 30% CDR. So that's but, a. That's
that,
Lucian
isn't that
a lot
Ghostblade
of damage
about
right now.
2,600 gold?
Exactly.
Similar to that. So basically, he literally has an item on this Varus at this point. This Varus hasn't even completed his Infinity Edge yet. But this is going to end badly for AX. Oh no, it might even end. It's just Varus is just doing no damage at this point.
And the Varus, is he going to go get the kill on Katarina? No, probably not.
Oh, but that
not.
Morgana roll is pretty good.
And
that gameplay,
this is a comeback. This could be a comeback right now. Or is it? Is Gnar super tanky right now?
But the
Gnar's
in. Let's see what his Gnar's got. He's going to kill it. Oh no, he missed it.
Oh no,
result.
The ult misses. But that is... Gnar got that kill as well. That's going to be Katarina going down. Not the best idea.
If he had his ult now,
Fatal
will be
dead. No, that is Gnar. That is not going down, and a triple kill for Lucian. The underdog comebacks were not real this time. Pretty sad stuff.
I think if Gnar hit his ult, that could have been a lot closer than it was. He would definitely have picked up like maybe one or two more kills there.
Exactly. Now we see Gangplank sitting on almost 2,000 gold right now.
Really?
He could just come back and go get a Rabadon's death cap if he wants to. If he just
man, he might even just save up for that Infinity Edge at this point.
exactly, he could.
Let's see how much gold this average. He still.
Ooh,
still...
and the perfect snare lands on to Sejuani. That was amazing.
I just feel bad for anyone.
Just an auto attack away, and the smite coming in to save Sejuani in time.
I feel bad for anyone that runs into this Lucian at this point. Because he is executing himself so well, and that Infinity Edge is finally picked up by It's the Triforce picked up by Gangplank, but that was kind of his first bad ult, really.
Exactly, that must have been a preemptive strike. They thought Amumu was going to ult in, but then,
maybe a little
and
bit
that's a lot of damage coming up from Ahri.
Yeah, Ahri's destroying at this point. Look at this now.
But we're
going to
see Amumu getting caught out right now. But then again, that is the Amumu. That is the tank. And Mega Gnar comes in.
Nah.
Is he going to do the rock throw?
And the
throws him all away.
With the Leona. No, the
missing
Leona
out on the Leona ult. That was miscommunication right there. But that still worked out.
Right
they got the kill on Amumu. But
right
I feel
now,
like they could have gotten
is live,
more.
So if they take another kill, AX could be looking for something
snare
right
lands
here.
In. The top range snare.
Oh,
and then
the
other top range there coming up from Morgana, and the ult comes in.
Oh, but the good Katarina
be
ult, but nothing really
Katarina
much from
going
it.
Down.
Gnar's ult has already been used up. Is
Ooh,
he going to pick up the Lucian? Yes, he is.
It gets a shutdown on the Lucian. Pretty low right now, though. It's just and the DFG kill coming in for Ahri. This is going to be a dead Sejuani right now. I've called it. Probably not. Probably going to queue away. What is going to happen right now? I have no idea. I'm
oh,
so
that's
nervous
a
right now.
Wasted ult, if you ask
and,
me.
And,
oh,
those jukes
away.
Are real. Those jukes are real. How much health did she run out with? Sejuani has only 32 HP right now. He probably made
honest,
it out with
probably
no health at all whatsoever.
And one more auto attack would have been her gone.
Exactly, but then she managed to live it out.
Oh, boy. Ahri's taking some towers, though she's overextending a little bit here. But nothing.
Pretty good escapes
of
coming from Sejuani this game.
Yeah, Sejuani is the Duke Master. Civ HD needs to take a lesson.
Exactly. Or MVC Katarina nearing death, but she soon pulls out in time.
The good ward hop, really, but they're clearing the wards. OG don't only have 3 sweepers at this point, considering they like usually have around 4. They don't seem to be that worried about any vision that AX actually have, because they're just stomping them so hard.
Exactly, and we see AX without any sweepers at all whatsoever. They really need the wards over the trinket, over the sweepers right now.
Yeah, the Sejuani's a little bit out of position right here. Oh, but the nail's coming down. That could be something scary if he's got his rage bar up. Is it up?
Oh, and we see Juke Master.
Oh,
Nell's
rage bar is right to the top as well. But no, nothing.
Exactly.
Made
things
from
could be really bad if they get caught out. But right now, they've literally sheathed Sejuani all the way onto the other side of the map right now.
Oh, but that Q onto that Varus's Q onto the Ahri then. Oh, but they're not looking to make some plays, but he's been caught out.
Oh, but no, that Gnar's gonna die. Couldn't even mega.
Oh, but the good old boy Amumu,
and
now he's standing in front
people.
Of him.
That's
gonna
be a dead no, but it is gonna be a dead yes, Leona.
I think this game is nearing over right now.
Dragon's
up in 8 seconds,
but
they're not even gonna bother going for it.
16,000 gold in the lead. This game has to pretty much go down to OG right now. And the ult misses.
If that was
an ult that hit, that could have been kills for Katarina.
Rotations. Not even rotations, but look at the Gangplank push. He's gonna get stuff.
Exactly, look at Gangplank just going from one lane to the next to push.
He's TPing down just to get the farm so he can farm up even more. He's even got his static shiv now, so he's got a lot of damage. One more item until he's got stupendous amounts, and that's the Infinity Edge. And how much gold
is he? You see the amount of assists on Gangplank right now, sitting on 15 assists. Probably
Gangplank,
half of those coming up from that ult.
And Gangplank has sitting on 2.3k at the moment, so he's not even that far away from his next item. That Gangplank hasn't even been that much of a presence in these team fights, but he's just been an annoyance. OG are pretty much winning this game 4v5 at this point.
Exactly, that's Ahri coming up with the kill and the perfect.
Sejuani did not have the
jukes
this time.
Frost is on a rampage, but so is Brutality.
Sejuani just didn't have the jukes this time. This Lucian is 14-1. He's got to be almost fully built. How much gold is he even sitting on? 3,300. Boy,
2,300 gold right now. He could probably buy himself a Ravidoth's death cap if he wants to. But he just picks up a pickaxe.
Did he not get anything else?
No,
maybe
he didn't get anything else.
Maybe he used the pink ward. They must be going for some objective control or something then. Or maybe
gotten the Yomamus. Or maybe the Infinity Edge. Probably the Infinity Edge, I guess.
Possibly. Yeah, that would make sense. Oh,
and
Meganar
gets queued down. But are we gonna see look at that very tiny shield.
Dejuani's ult isn't even up, so let's see what happens here. That Gnar's almost out of Mega Gnar.
Oh wow,
they've got it back out. That Varus looks like he's dead meat. He hasn't got flash.
He's eating those oranges.
Oh my god.
Did you see that? How much damage was that? Did he just one shot?
I think so. Really, there was a dark binding involved as well. I think there was a dark binding involved as well, but still.
So that is a ton of damage coming up from Gangplank.
Currently
that
has 273 AD plus the 100 from the static shiv, plus the extra 200.
Wow, he just ate some oranges and now he's okay.
Yeah, Gangplank for you.
Gangplank is actually a very good counter for Varus. I just realized that snare. If Gangplank comes close to the snare, he can just eat oranges and walk away.
Yeah, the one problem right now for OG, they can't seem to actually close out this game. They've been dominating for the last, like, 10,
see, that's the problem with these games nowadays. That's the problem with these games nowadays with the new patches. It's really hard to finish games. You always have to go through Baron. You always have to go get Baron, and you're not strong enough usually for Baron. It's too much of a risk until the near end of the
enough,
game.
Though I think Gangplank just wants his Infinity Edge before he goes any further, to be honest. Then he can just easily... Oh, he's even going Infinity Edge right now. 3-0-17. Excellent performance by Distinct right here.
Exactly. If he had a Sword of the Occult at the start of the game, he'd probably have full stacks.
He would have full stacks. Like, straight up, I think. I don't know, either way.
Full stacks.
Though I don't think he would have done as well in game, so I wouldn't have gone for the Sword of the Occult on Gangplank, not necessarily.
Dude, it doesn't really make much sense.
But either way, this Gangplank damage. Oh my god. This poor Gnar, let's see this damage on this Q that's gonna... Oh, I didn't even come... I wanted to see the Q damage right there on the tanky member.
So did I, Exactly, that would have been a huge chunk, though, I bet.
Just cripple... Oh!
Ooh, and the scrying arm, and the charm misses.
But Gangplank's on the split push, just dodged around that Sejuani.
Are they actually
gonna
go for them?
Oh, and they picked up the Gnar! But no, they backed off now. Decided they didn't want
to engage. Lucian's downstairs getting red buff right now. Ooh, and the rock throw misses. No Geodude, you can't get that done right.
Yeah, right now, that the only thing that could be a saving grace is if OG do something stupid and engage under tower, and Gnar can just get a monster like... he's going to have to get like a 4-5 man ult off to turn this game around.
Look at Gangplank just hunting for a Q poke right now. Oh, and there we see it! Wow!
Did
you see that?
But look, they're taking Baron right now. I didn't actually see it because I was paying attention to Baron, but I assume that Katarina was on full HP.
Exactly, that...
Oh, but they're looking to struggle a little bit right here. And Lucian made the mistake of going towards the back of the Baron pit, which actually does more damage. So you'll notice when everyone stands near the front, because the spikes at the back of Baron does more damage.
And oh, there's the Sejuani steals the Baron! Are we going to see the comebacks happening right now? Not really.
Dude, now this is why Sejuani is a really good person to steal, because she can just stun out whoever.
Ooh, oh, okay, so that's not too much damage, I guess,
but
coming up onto Gnar.
Yeah, but that Gnar is sitting on quite, like, enough armor at the moment, to be honest. He's
exactly.
He's currently got 150, opposed to this Katarina's 74, so, I mean...
Oh, I guess the Q needs to crit to do tons of damage.
Yeah, that's also true. That's true. Oh, wow. Though they could turn this right here because they've got the Baron buff, they could, but they don't even want to push. They just don't want to push at this point. They're scared.
Exactly, things are looking
pretty
bad.
They're trying
right
to
now
keep themselves in the game. Like, oh, look at, there we go.
I
There's
love
a
that. I love that recall animation. It's my favorite. Billy, can you buy me Popstar Artie?
No.
On Europe.
Yeah. Baron throw hype, yes, definitely Baron throw hype.
Oh, and the Leona juice coming in. The Morgana shield coming in.
Oh my god.
Leona giving up on life, except
poor Leona. But there was a Lucian flash out of that, so I guess that's a small advantage. That's a kind of an advantage.
Doesn't really make up for the fact that the support's dead, Billy.
Yeah, I know, but right now, that's any advantage is an advantage to AX right now. A dragon's up in 8 seconds. I'm quite surprised they're not prepping for it.
Exactly, and Gangplank took a lot of turn shots right there, but then again, he ate an orange, and then it was all okay.
Yeah, but they're not even prepping for Dragon right now. They could get the Dragon and then clear the Baron buff minions even better, because the the extra damage that they
Team
have...
Team AX has not taken they have not taken one Baron this entire game.
Dragon, you mean? I know that... No, Team AX have taken the Baron, mate. You mean the Dragon, they haven't taken the Dragon.
They haven't taken the Dragon the whole game, and that was a crit coming on to Sejuani. That was a good poke coming on from Gangplank to the tanky member.
I wonder
what
Gangplank is going to build as his last item. This is an interesting pickup.
Let's look at how close Gangplank is on his last item. He's sitting on 1,800 gold right now.
So he could go back
away,
and buy an item.
From another
I wonder if he's going to go for like a GA or something to keep his perfect score.
Probably going to go with the GA. You know how everyone goes for a 6th item GA. That's never a wrong option.
Yeah, especially he might be just wanting to keep that perfect score going, which I totally do. And they're retaining for Dragon right now to get that 4th Dragon going. So, and they're close to that 5th Dragon.
Yeah, exactly. And after this one Dragon, they're probably going to go Super Saiyan Dragon.
Yeah, I mean, I don't feel like AX can do much right now. Gangplank's caught a little out of position, though, but he's far too fast for anyone on their team.
Exactly, look at Gangplank just running away, covering up
that,
more
that
distance.
That was too
Sejuani
long of a chase. They should
up.
Have looked at his speed, especially with his E, he could just keep rocking that. Oh, look, they take the OG securing the blue buff right there. So both the jungler and the ADC have it, and blue buff's quite nice on a Lucian, to be honest.
Exactly. A lot more CDR. Well, 10% CDR, and then a lot of mana regen, which Lucian really needs because he's a pretty spell heavy champion.
Oh boy!
Ooh, and we see
looks
the
like someone's going down.
In, but that's still
Lucian
gonna be enough to give Lucian the death. It's Sejuani.
But that Katarina's not got the resets to keep going or the
but
damage.
But then the Gangplank all just does too much damage, and Sejuani goes down. Actually, no, that was Gangplank himself taking the kill. Special ops Gangplank. Oh, and the crit onto that Leona. That was so much damage.
OG don't even need their ADC to finish this game. They're just gonna take this and go. They were too far out. They may
exactly,
have thought it was
good.
There's
finally the strong gates of Team AX. It took them 33 minutes to take down that inhibitor. It's finally been broken down, and now we're nearing the end.
How long
to
this
game.
Baron buff time until it comes up?
Well, I don't know, Billy. I just don't know.
They might be looking to try do that again, unless it gets stolen away from them.
Exactly, they really needed that Baron buff. They had to push in spite of the Baron.
Now, all things considering, I feel like Gnar and Sejuani are the only ones actually keeping AX in the game right now. Because, well, just look at the scores.
Big 0-20 on Gnar, 2-1-13 on Amumu, 10-4-10 on Ahri, 14-2-10 on Lucian, 5-2-23 on Morgana.
The 14-12-10. That GP with his perfect score, and I called it, he's gone for the GA. He doesn't want to lose his perfect score.
Exactly. Now we're looking at a full build Gangplank right now. I guess we...
But there's no more damage,
really,
but has he picked up an elixir is the question. Oh, but wait, let's watch this play first. Oh, it's just
ooh,
too late for this Leona. And
that
doesn't even want to try this. He's going to get destroyed. I don't know what
exactly,
they're trying
that's
here.
Katarina.
This Lucian's huge.
Even before she could ult, Lucian just goes ahead for the kill.
Let's just check this Gangplank. He does have an Elixir of Ruin, so he's going to deal even more damage right now.
Wow, that's
going
to be a
lot. Oh boy, that
tower
is going down right now. They're just destroying it. They don't even need
it. Wait,
I
thought that was Elixir of Wrath.
Oh yeah, Wrath, that's right. New items.
Yeah, he got Wrath right now.
Yeah.
Oh my god, this is probably going to be game. This is probably the game-winning push.
And even if it's not game right here, they can just back off and take Baron at this point, because they're so far ahead.
Exactly, and this is probably going to be it. This is probably going to be game.
Yeah, they don't even need it. I'm not saying that they need it. I'm just saying, if somehow AX actually managed to keep them off, they need to fight, and they need to do it now. Otherwise, it's just GG. The Leona's making the engage.
Exactly,
Gnar's
that's
going for
the
2-9-0.
They
got the Gangplank down.
Worked amazingly
Gangplank
for
is down.
Them. So
AX
many kills coming in.
The
defense coming in.
But no one focused on the AC.
It's a 2-for-2, but things still look pretty bad. And yeah, it's gone from bad to worse. And only Katarina's left. This is probably going to be a quadra kill.
Oh, they want the
Lucian
penta.
Right now. Katarina
don't
refusing to give away the pentakill.
Katarina, you.
Katarina not willing to give that pentakill over.
She wants the
1v1. Is she?
Yes,
no.
The pentakill.
And Gangplank takes the kill in the end. No
penta
for Lucian. And that is game over right now. Very definitive victory coming out from Team OG right now.